and welcome to my channel. Today I've got a... Well, I started out trying to do a makeup tutorial. It turned into more of a get ready with me slash shop my stash slash accidental challenge. Yeah. I ended up using only cream products on my eyes, which is not something I'm used to. So yeah, I'm pretty pleased with how it turned out. It's a bit of a smoky eye moment. With some shimmers and big lashes and stuff like that. So yeah, this entire thing was a bit of a... It was a process. So let's get started. Today I'm starting off with a foundation in my actual skin color. Be very afraid, I'm going to look ghostly. This is the shade 05N by L'Oreal True Match, by the way. Which really, it is gorgeous in terms of like quality. Like, I really like the True Match foundations. But this one, well, I bought it, I tried it, I realized this is my perfect shade in winter. And then I realized I was probably not gonna wear it very often. Because it was just a bit too pale. I do actually have it in my professional kit. Which right now, with the entire like situation and all, I obviously am not using, so I thought I might just apply it on myself again. But even in my professional kit, I actually solely use this shade in order to, blend it with other foundations to make those paler. Because seriously, on itself, it's really, it's perfect for Halloween. Next up, brows. You can see a distinct difference. I'm just mixing my brow products, the brow pomade, on the little lids of the product, as I always do. I just feel like it applies more smoothly that way. But yeah, anyway, I'm going for vintage vibes today. By which I mean, like 50s, because it fits with my dress. I'm going for more of a 50s fusion, because as you can tell, my eyebrows are way thicker than they were in the 50s. But my personal eyebrows, of course, they didn't exist in the 50s. But like, the style back then was way thinner in terms of eyebrows. I almost held my brush upside down. But I don't want to make them that thin. I'm going for more of a vintage fusion. So like, vintage vibes, but at the same time, not completely vintage. Like red lips, like a wicked winged eyeliner and all. But, with the beauty standards of the 21st century, so not super thin brows. I feel like I haven't done my brows this way in like ages, so I really hope I can get them to look even. First off, we're going to apply product. I applied way too much on the other eye, so now I'm going to have to also apply way too much on the other eye. Yeah, let me just aim my mirror. But I'm using the Alice Faas taupe cream eyeshadow again that I reviewed a couple of videos ago. It's really good. You really don't need to apply as much as I did on the other eye, and you know, it's easier to just match this eye than to try and remove product. But yeah, anyway, in terms of vintage stuff, what I wanted to chat about as well. Back in the olden days, they obviously... How did I get a black stripe there? That's so weird. But yeah, they didn't have internet. It was a hair of a brush, but not this brush. I'm weirded out. Point being, back in the olden days, they obviously did not have internet and all. And on that note, yesterday a lot of people, it was Sunday yesterday, and a lot of people did a like internet and like phone free Sunday yesterday. I didn't, because, you know, I didn't want to be bored. I don't know, because a lot of people seem to feel these days like they're almost addicted to their phone. And I was wondering, like, how is that for you? Like, do you ever feel like you're addicted to your phone, like you're on your phone too much and thereby, like, miss important things or miss opportunities to do stuff because you were distracted by your phone? I gotta admit, I personally actually never really feel like that. I'm more of the type of person who... Like, for example, if I'm at work and one of my friends texts me, then it might very well happen that I see it, be like, I'm working, I'll respond later, and then 3 days later I realize, oh, I've accidentally ignored a friend for the past 3 days. Damn it. Yeah. I'm not a bad friend, by the way. Like, if it's really important, you just gotta call me and not text me, okay? That's basically the thing to take away from that. But yeah, at any rate, it's... I don't know, like, I'm not the sort of person who ever feels like she needs to check her phone. Now, for my brow bone highlight, I'm going to use a pencil. And I'm applying more on this eye because I blended it too high. This is starting to become more of a cream product makeup challenge, really, than a tutorial. I can't guarantee you what the results are going to look like, just so you know. But yeah, anyway, so yeah, that's really, like, I just don't feel like I'm on my phone too much. Like, I'm more of the sort of person, for example, when am I on Twitter? When I'm on the toilet, doing a big one, because otherwise I get bored. No, really, I think we all know that feeling. Please tell me you also do the same thing, because otherwise I'll feel really lonely. That if you've, like, forgotten to take your phone to the toilet, and you just start reading, like, the entire text on the back of the little, like, soap thingy in French, because it takes longer. I seriously do that, because I can't stand being bored on the toilet for some reason. But yeah, so that's basically the main use of my phone. Then up next is a shimmer. This is actually by Catrice because I don't have a pale shimmer by Alice Faas and I want a pale shimmer. So, yeah. But yeah, that's really my conclusion. I mostly just use my phone to not be bored. And it really just comes down to... I check my phone when I'm on the toilet, like I said. Or when I'm just, I don't know, like when I'm making tea and I'm waiting for the water to start boiling. That sort of thing. But I never really do feel like the need to like check social media regularly. Checking Instagram, for example, for me is also something I either do when I just, you know, genuinely am interested in, you know, seeing what people have posted on Instagram. Or again, when I'm waiting for the water to start boiling when I'm making tea. But I don't feel like I'm missing anything if I, like, don't check it an entire day. Okay, no matter how much I love Catrice, I gotta admit, you can really tell that the Alice Faas product is a lot more smooth than the Catrice stuff, which is a little bit flaky. I mean, I do still like how it looks, it's just, yeah, you can tell the difference. But anyways, the pale nude pencil is also going to function as my inner corner highlight today. Okay, I gotta admit, I'm not sure if this is what I want or not. I think I'm gonna try to find a darker product to put in my outer corners. Okay, I'm using this shade, which is Maybelline Color Tattoo in the shade Knockout, a name which I know by heart just simply because I find it such a weird name for an eyeshadow shade, like Knockout. Huh? But anyways, it's a dark purple burgundy-ish shade, which I think blends quite nicely over the rest of it. Just using the exact same blending brushes all along, by the way. Okay, but now I've moved on to eyeliner and somehow I managed to have a little bit of fallout and a random piece of dust on my face while I was using cream eyeshadows. I find that very interesting. For some reason I've also managed to grab, I'm not sure what I was thinking like 5 seconds ago. But I grabbed an eyeliner that I haven't actually used in a while because I've really been into the Epic Ink Liner by NYX lately. So I decided to just grab one with a brush tip again for some reason. This one is by HEMA. I do actually like it, but this might go horribly wrong. Okay, so this eye took me ages and, you know, I had to fix it and everything. This eye was like, chuk-chuk, done. So annoying. Anyway, but yeah, I think I'm just gonna fix my face first now. Okay, I gotta admit, I almost just made a horrific mistake on this eye. I had already applied my eyeshadow below my eye as well. It's just one of those tiny little details that might be fun to actually, you know, remember and all when you're doing your makeup. So instead of grabbing my big brush like originally planned, I'm grabbing a small blending brush and blending the concealer downwards, and then only the last teeny tiny bit is going to be blended towards the eyeshadow to blend it all together rather than to do what I almost did on the other eye and blend it all over the eyeshadow. So I would have had to reapply the eyeshadow and given myself way more work for no good reason. Don't be like me, think before you act. For a moment I was contemplating doing a cream contour and then I realized I was going for vintage vibes and they didn't really contour a lot. So moving on to powder immediately, but I am starting at my T-zone. Just so my under eye concealer has a little bit of time to dry. Okay, first off now back to the eyes. My waterline is getting the nude pencil. Okay, next up mascara. I'm going to apply my falsies all the way at the ends, just for the sake of my contact lenses. But yeah, I'm using the Anastasia mascara, which I also reviewed in my review video of the products. It's very nice if you're going to use falsies or if you want to go for a really, really natural look. It wasn't supposed to go up there though, admittedly. But anyways, because it really does separate the lashes really well and it makes them look very nice and dark yet natural. But it's not going to give you a false lash effect on its own, so keep that in mind. Now I am adding a little bit of bronzer just because I would prefer to not look like something that hasn't seen the sun in the past 40 years. I am not even 40 years old, so that would be especially tragic. Next up a peachy blush, and this time I am using one with shimmer. Okay, I just forgot that you need to use like 3 molecules when you're this pale. So I'm just going over it with my powder brush to blend it a little bit more. Okay, that's all, and instead of our highlighter we're going to go for a glowy setting spray. Okay, then for the lips I'm going to use the Anastasia red shade, which is red. I'm not sure why I felt the need to point it out. Anyway, and then I'm just going to quickly apply my lashes and we're done. And here we have the final results. I really hope you enjoyed watching this video. If you did enjoy it, please click the like button, it would really help me out. And if you want to see more of my videos, you can always subscribe to my YouTube channel. The reason I ask about the likes, by the way, really is because the more likes a video gets, the more often YouTube shows it to new people. So it just helps the video reach more people. Yeah. Anyways, other than that, as always, everything I've used on my face will be listed below the video in the description. And again, as always, you don't need to use the exact same products. Actually, you could easily also do this eye look with powder products instead of cream products, obviously. Although, I do gotta say that now that I'm looking at it, cream products do seem to give more of a glowy finish. A more lively finish, I suppose, rather than a matte finish of eyeshadow. So, if you're going for something a little bit more almost natural looking, then I would actually recommend going for creams. I need to use more cream products, really. I used to have a lot more cream products. I still have them. They're Maybelline Color Tattoos, but I've had them for so long that they're dried out. So really the thing that I need to learn from my own video this time around is to get more cream products and then actually proceed to use them before they dry out. Yes. Anyway, so yeah, that's something for you in the future. For now at any rate, thank you very much for watching this video. I hope you have a wonderful day and I hope to see you next time. Bye.